Imagine that you can get roughly 1 billion joules of energy in mere fractions of a second. That can power a 60 watt light bulb for 6 months. What if this energy is renewable, eco-friendly and enormous? What if we can create that much of energy whenever we want and in a more efficient way? The idea of lightning as a power source isn't such a better idea now. This can be same in the future. Creating lightning bolts whenever we want energy and using them to power everything. The energy of a thunderstorm is equal to that of an atom bomb. There have been several attempts to find the possibility of harvesting lightning energy since the late 1980s. In 2007, an alternative company called Alternate Energy Holdings tested a method for capturing the energy in lightning bolts. The design for the system had been purchased from an Illinois inventor named Steve Leroy, who had reportedly been able to power a 60 watt light bulb for 20 minutes using the energy captured from a small flash of artificial lightning. According to Donald Gillispie, CEO of AEHI, they couldn't make it work although given enough time and money. You should probably scale this thing up. It's not black magic, it's truly math and science, and it could happen. Physics tells us that we can store and retrieve this energy with 100% efficiency. There are a lot to consider when we think of lightning energy. Let's look at the figures first. The average American household consumes 41 billion joules of energy each year, which means it would take 41 lightning bolts to power a house. There are 114 households in the US, which means that the US requires 4.72 quintillion joules to power all its houses. This number is pretty meaningless to most, but it basically signifies that the energy in all the lightning bolts on Earth in a year could only power 8% of US homes. Considering atmospheric physics, the greatest challenge is that the 1 billion joules of energy in the lightning bolt is released in mere fractions of a second in the form of heat, sound, and electrical energy. In order to convert this energy into useful electricity and storing it would require a capacitor capable of charging up instantly and then slowly and steadily releasing the energy when it's needed. Such devices are incredibly difficult and expensive to create, and worst of all, very inefficient. Another major challenge when attempting to harvest energy from lightning is the impossibility of predicting when and where thunderstorms will occur. Even during a storm, it's very difficult to tell where exactly lightning will strike. There is no constant power observed in lightning strikes. In some lightning strikes, the power can be much higher than the average, while in others, it is fairly low. You never know if an upcoming lightning strike is going to carry a positive or negative charge. Capacitors and rectifiers would also be necessary to equalize the currents of incoming strikes. MIT professor James Kirtley says, "You would need some sort of mechanism to make sure the positive charge of one bolt didn't cancel out the negative charge of another." The better idea is artificial lightning. Artificially triggered lightning can be achieved in two ways. This can be done by launching specially designed rocket trailing spools of wire into thunderstorms. The wire unwinds as the rocket ascends, creating an elevated ground that can attract descending leaders. If a leader attaches, the wire provides a low resistance pathway for a lightning flash to occur. The wire is vaporized by the return current flow, creating a striped lightning plasma channel in its place. This method allows for scientific research of lightning to occur under a more controlled and predictable manner. The International Center for Lightning Research and Testing at Camp Blanding, Florida, typically uses rocket-triggered lightning in their research studies. Another method is laser-triggered method. This method is also known as directing plasma channels. This is to trigger lightning strikes by means of infrared or ultraviolet lasers, which create a channel called LIPC, laser-induced plasma channel of ionized gas, through which the lightning would be conducted to predicted location on ground. Such triggering of lightning is intended to protect rocket launching pads, electric power facilities, and other sensitive targets. A rare cause of lightning is due to pyrocumulonimbus clouds. During extreme forest fires, The complete intensity of fires generates their own storm clouds, which results lightning. This is one of the major causes for long Australian fires recently. Professor Kirtley remains hopeful that the challenges of lightning capture, if not its economic feasibility, will one day be met. Just because we don't harness lightning now doesn't mean some smart engineer out there won't someday figure out how to do it.